poem is entitled Azania, of which was a recommended name for South Africa at some point in time. And also I want to make mention that today it's Black Friday. I also want to mention that today it's Black Friday, and the historical knowledge about Black Friday, we know that this was a time when black people were being auctioned during the transatlantic slave. People were being sold actually very cheap to black people specifically.
Is this the one?
Yeah, that's the one. Exactly.
This one.
Scraped the skies and summer brought the sun rays casting shadows until the difference tells about the difference that drips off the melanin in my father's head. And that's how I became keen to the darkness I am. A foreman limp with a profusion of supplies, all within the rigid constraints for a blueprint for my design timetable for completion. And in testimonial mute, my imagination has accomplished the impossible. See, my heart beats from a different position this evening. Even Eve denies the fragments ripped off my cage. When my lungs contract with breath of truth, diaphragm strain. So I position my stones at the centers of the earth where the heavy dark cloud finds its buoyant favor with the crust and it never let go. And you need to understand that there will be no world involved unless I open my eyes and Azania's ankles are still shackled with the same irons from yesterday's grief, and the only common ground he shares with his siblings is the authority we bear the oligarchs of our former. My muse, balanced mantra eyes pierced into the sky, bending rainbows so they dissipate into the blue, into a dream that sought to fertilize this barren land when we kneel. And now I present my wrists and carpals, wounded by the scratch, in search for better springs. A lighter struggle fluctuates from this revolutionary tongue-tied speech when you're seated on that white armchair and the silence of your history throws darts of doubts upon your life's target black. I'm here to remind you that our souls are liberated from its bodied impediments. We are born from the pillaged temples that carry inscriptions addressed to the neophytes. See, ours is a social plight. A dauntless and courageous people, confined in the stillness of our solitude. What we need is our brotherhood. We need our sisters to strap the lineage of our descendants across their bending spines. Take a leap out of the struggle, out of the misery of our dusty street. So we're still gonna pray, with palms placed over our innocent heads, reciting verses that further drifts us away from ancestral craftsmanship, breaking our knees to take mass on Sunday, whilst we further drift away from our traditional self, away from our ancestral craft, away from the thin-skinned drums that reminds us from where we come from. I think.